So we at the beach right now, and she's taking selfies, and I'm just talking, and this is what it's like, endless amount of water right now. So see all that stuff. See the. See the Ferris wheel, we got the roller coasters, you got all these people over here and all that good stuff, and then you got that building to look like Miami, but this is not Miami, this is Santa Monica, so yeah. Here is Santa Monica. You got raising water. That water is cold.
Oh my god.
That water is cold.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Let me pull my pants up. That water is cold though. I'm gonna walk down here, walk back up here. I'm gonna walk up and then I'll circle back and I'll so yeah. So we got people over here. Got people over here. Got the mountains in the background. See the mountains. We got more water coming up. More water. Yeah, the water is cold. That's what it's like out here because it's so much stuff. You gotta stay warm, but it's not obviously not warm. Do you have anything you want to say?
I am not used to this at all, but I'm enjoying it. I like
you enjoying it because like it's the beach.
And water comes up on shore pretty quick. If you don't watch out, it'll get you.
Back at home, we don't have beaches. We got rivers, so we can't do nothing with a river.
Yeah, we got dirty rivers.
We got rivers, so that we can see across, but you can't see across this because it's an ocean and it's endless. So yeah, it's an endless ocean, pretty much. Endless ocean. Thank you.
They got souvenirs. Hollywood. Got these things. What is this? Freaking Hollywood. Dang. We got Hollywood cups. $6 stuff. I ain't think I'm gonna pay that much for that. California cups. Got these. What else? I think it's $6 and $7. This is the other side. Yeah, this side of the water is not too clean though. Let's see. Yeah, look at all that though. This is the ocean, so it's unlimited water. We got helicopters in the sky, so. Let's keep it going. Getting further in, though. Something else, that view is something. Oh, we're getting back, all the way back to the back. All the way back. We go even further now. We even further back now. So you can get those two buildings, you can get
these three. Yeah, this is the whole view of the beach. Still ain't back as far as I want though, but yeah, this is further back though.
But so I was in one of those little spinning thingies. And you move it, it turns right the heart.
Yeah.
Shooting a video out here. I don't know what they shooting, but they shooting something. Got a whole camera crew. Yep. Going down. Sun's going down. This is Grand Theft Auto all the way. It's just like it. Just like Grand Theft Auto. Just like Grand Theft Auto. It's just like it. The bike trail and all that stuff is Grand Theft Auto, all of it. Take pictures of car and stuff. You ready? Just about. I'm just getting video and stuff.
Okay, I'm ready. Go that way.
In the speed though. Yeah, say something. Okay, it's crazy, man. Crazy. What time is this thing leaving again? $3.25. What time is it now?
Yes.
Hello. That's a beat.
Oh, I see you, Pig and Listen.
Where is it at? So you got on your LA hat now.
Yes, I do.
Back to me.
Yeah, we're gonna be going probably down the street. Oh, no, no. Taking selfies. Yep. I'm just here right now. Getting ready to leave.
Have you got tickets?
On this trip.
Take this.
Just waiting on stuff to happen. That's the what's the name bar over there.
TV. They're all wound up about their football game over there, I guess. Very exciting, right? So this is Las Palmas here, Avenue of the Palms. Over on the right-hand side over here, we'll go by the Las Palmas Hotel. And this is where Richard Gere climbs up the fire escape at the end of Pretty Woman there to get his true love right there.
Yeah, that's right. That's the actual...
Now, this area, have gone on in this area over the
history.
Years.
History.
This is... If you would go back in time here in the past millions of years, 45 million years ago, this area was populated by dinosaurs. And then there was an ice age, right? And the ice was actually 2 miles thick in some spots. California, if you can imagine that. And then the ice melted for one reason or another. And then in the year 1000, the Vikings came through here, led by Leif Erikson. The first Spaniard arrives on the shores of Los Angeles in 1541, Juan Rodriguez Cabrillo. And the Spaniards were here in 1761. This area was owned by the King of Spain, the Conquistadors. Famous.
How are you doing this?
In the 1800s, this was all farmland. This was owned by Wilcox, Mrs. Wilcox, naming the farm Hollywood. Over on the right-hand side over here is the Hollywood Heritage Museum, that old barn there, and that was on the down there on Hollywood, by Hollywood and Selma, Hollywood Vine and Selma, 103 years ago, and Cecil B. DeMille rented it. That was Paramount Pictures. That barn was in the movie The Squaw Man. It was also an episode of Bonanza. Was the barn originally was white. I have photos of it from years ago in one of my old books. But other than that, it's the same barn. Over on the left-hand side, we're going to Hollywood Bowl, the largest outdoor amphitheater in America. Built by Lloyd Wright. That's the first place that the Beatles did a performance here. They did a performance in 1964. The first place the Beatles recorded music in America was Hollywood, Capitol Records building. That was 1963. By William Mulholland, and this will take you all the way to the, you know, El Pacifico, right?
Close to that.
And William Mulholland, you know, he built infrastructure all over the state of California. He diverted the Owens Sierra Nevadas. He and his men installed thousands of miles of water pipe in the city here. And William Mulholland had no education. He never went to school. He worked in mines as a young boy. That was his education.
You don't need it.
Curse on it. If you look to the left, you can see that little house there with the infinity pool. That's the iced tea house. The yellow house at the bottom is the Ben Stiller home. I can't get where I want to get today. I can't show you a house there because there's a sun's in my way there. I was going to show you a house, but forget it. And the sun's right there, you'll blind you. Yeah, don't look over there. Don't look at the sun, right? My mom told me that. I kept doing it. Yeah, don't look at the sun. If you look up here on the right-hand side, you can see like some houses sticking out a little bit as we go. That's a private neighborhood up above. That's where they filmed E.T., directed by Steven Spielberg. E.T. neighborhood. E.T.
E.T. That's what it's going to be, E.T.
Right. Over on the left-hand side, you can see the opening of trees or some homes over there. That's one of the properties of Katy Perry there. One of the properties in the area. She owns another large one, but it's too far away to show you. Right up here, we're coming up to Runyon Canyon. They do lots of hiking up here, celebrities sometimes. They did filming here, The Biggest Loser. This is the Hollywood Hills now, Highway to the Sea. So we'll just continue on the Highway to the Sea. Yeah. Right up on the hill to the front, straight up on the front, you see that big white home on the ridge there? That's the Jake Gyllenhaal house. Yeah. And right on the left over here, this one, she was married to Mark Anthony. They did a magazine spread on it, you know, maybe you have it, you can archive it, and they go inside the house. She had the floors done in marble and stuff, and you can see that, you can't see it now, but when it's clear from that house, you can look out the window. They have photos of it in the magazine, because I used to have it. You can see the ocean, the coastline. Yeah, they divide it all up. I think it's a five-story condo now. One of the houses that used to belong to Charlie Chaplin is like a 44-room apartment building now. Can you imagine that? His house is like big enough for 44 apartments. That's why he's not home right now. But of course, he was married to Madonna, engaged to Charlize Theron, had the meeting with El Chapo, the drug lord. I know what everybody drives around here pretty much.
Pretty much. Apparently.
If you look up to the right here, you can see the Quentin Tarantino home on the hill with the sun shining on it, the big home. Quentin Tarantino. He's only making two more movies and he's retiring. He announced that. He's going to make 10 movies. He's made 8. He's making 2 more and then he's going to retire. He announced that on the radio yesterday. Yeah. That's the Seth MacFarlane place on the right-hand side here, American Dad. American Dad cartoons. He does other things as well. That's the home of Sacha Baron Cohen. And that would be the Borat, the dictator, the Brothers Grimsby. He's in the movie Beyond the Looking Glass with Johnny Depp and other movies as well. That's the other end of his driveway right here, 1640. I'm going to stop up ahead because this isn't a good place to stop.
Nice.
But that's all the city of Burbank over there on the right-hand side, you know, Universal Studios, NBC, Warner Brothers, Disney Studios. That area of land in the valley down there is where they filmed Gone with the Wind with Clark Gable. It's where, down in the valley, is where they built the little town from 1955 for the movie Back to the Future. Michael J. Fox, Christopher Lloyd. Out to the base of the mountain out there, you'll see the way out of the base of the mountain there, you'll see the Bob Hope Airport. And then all the buildings to the right there, that's Studio City. That's where they do a lot of television. Hollywood is number one in the world in television. Number one television city. Yeah. It's all about television, right? I don't even have a television.
You don't have a television?
No television. They love to get chased around by zombies. They can't get enough of that.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, he used to be in the Young and the Restless. He has a home out in Zuma Canyon, too, by Malibu. Over on the left up here, you'll see a big white house on the hill. That's one of the buildings of Larry Flint. Larry Flint has a high-rise on Wilshire with a penthouse. He also has another mansion in Beverly Hills. Right. We'll go by the Flint building on Sunset as well. Woody Harrelson made a movie about Larry Flint. You know, he's a colorful character, right? To say the least.
What?
Yeah, Bruno Mars, he's a singer, yeah. I've seen Bruno Mars a couple times. Seen him around. He's around, he hangs around, you know. The property is Zac Efron. You go right up Woodrow Wilson to the left is the Silver Gate, the Zac Efron Gate on the left, yeah? Now we're good, about 8 minutes here, this is a scenic drive. About 8 minutes, this will take us to Beverly Hills. So we'll just follow this scenic highway to the sea here. And it's winter right now in Mount Whitney. And winter stays in Mount Whitney till the middle of July. There's snow. The Yosemite Indians was discovered in the 1870s by a guy chasing a grizzly bear all the way from Oregon. Now this is the Wild West out here. I'm somewhat of a mountain man. I've climbed peaks in California, and I mean, there's people missing around here. You know what I mean? Yeah, you go missing in the mountains around here, they may not ever find you. Now, this is a very, oh yeah, this is the Wild West for real. You know what I mean? I mean, we got cell phones and cars, right, and television sets. But it's still the Wild West, and we don't have Indians shooting at us anymore. But you still got the mountain and the oceans and the snow, the blizzards, Death Valley, the hottest point on Earth, right? 248 feet below sea level, that's in California. That's about 3 hours from here. You would take the Mojave Desert. And when you're in the Mojave, take the 14 of the Mojave, and then you would take Furnace Creek Road. And Furnace Creek will wind way, way down into Death Valley, 248 feet below sea level.
Whoa.
248. We're on the highway to the sea here. We gotta keep going. We don't turn back now. So we don't turn back though. And the Spanish roof, that's the Jack Nicholson house. To the right of the Jack Nicholson house was the Marlon Brando home. He bought that home when Marlon Brando passed away. He paid $5 million for the Marlon Brando home. That's Beverly Ridge. It's a private community of Beverly Hills. This is Coldwater. Coldwater, 300 years ago, before man came and paved everything, when it rained, this would have been a river flowing down into a big lake down where Rodeo Drive is. And they called it Coldwater Canyon. And this will take us into Beverly Hills. Now, the beginning of the founding of Beverly Hills is the year 1769. And it began with what was called the Portola Expedition, which was led by Colonel Portola. Jed Clampett. His family was the Beverly Hillbillies, and he was an oil tycoon. Jed Clampett struck oil in Los Angeles in 1867. He died in 1919. In 1905, A.F. Gilmore is a farmer, and he has a farm on what is today 3rd and Fairfax. That would be CBS Studios. He's drilling for water, and he strikes oil. Gilmore Oil is born. Gilmore is the founder of Mobil. 1910, had their largest gold repository in the world from his mother when he was 8 years old. Bernie Ecclestone lives here today. He's the owner of Harbor Freight, he's the owner of Formula One Racing. Michael Eisner lives here in a $100 million home, CEO of Disney. Walt Disney lived here. Elvis Presley lived here. Mel Gibson, who has had the most expensive divorce in Hollywood history, paying his wife $500 million in divorce settlement. The Johnson & Johnson family lives here. That family earning $2.3 million per day. Donald Sterling owns property and buildings in Beverly Hills. A multi-billionaire and Aaron Spelling lived here.
What about you?
Worth about $6 billion when he passed. The Sultan of Brunei has a property here. We'll go buy it. There are over 100 princes from the Middle East in Beverly Hills. Most people know nothing of the oil. Los Angeles is the third largest oil producer in the United States.
Didn't know that either.
There's enough oil in Los Angeles to power all the fuel usage of the United States of America at the present rate of consumption for hundreds of years. Beverly Hills is a big part of the oil. It's all hidden from the public, of course. The oil derricks are nondescript buildings. Bank. And,
yes.
How did you
know? Spoil everything.
Told you. Kind of like we need to see this. It's like that boy with the top. With the top letting us go at 20. 15. Like, right. We need to see this.
When we go by this wall over here on the right hand side, if you look up on the hill, you're going to see a mega mansion sitting on the hill. It's one of the many homes that was built by William Randolph Hearst. It was built as a gift for his girlfriend, Marion Davies. The home recently sold for $129 million. The property tax is $1.3 million on that house. And that brings us to the bottom of Coldwater. We're going to see two guardhouses. The main home is not visible. This is a home that was built by William Randolph Hearst. This is where they did filming of The Godfather, starring Marlon Brando and Al Pacino. And it's also where William Randolph Hearst died in the master bedroom. That home was valued today at about $56 million. Of course, he built homes and castles all over the world. In 1878, Burton E. Green announces to the paper he has purchased the farm west of Los Angeles and is going to develop it for the ruling class. The first thing done, the aquifer was capped, building Rodeo Water and Power. The second thing done, every tree you see was put in the ground by men. It's all man-made. Palm trees are not indigenous. They tell people there's no water here and they put up palm trees. They tell you it's a desert and there's no water here. Palm trees are not indigenous, they were all brought in. There's a lot of water here. There's a lot of oil here. That's why this is 3% of the most expensive real estate in the world. Over to the right-hand side over here, you're gonna see the oldest building in Beverly Hills, the Beverly Hills Hotel. It opened its doors in 1910. It was built by Burton E. Green's men. That is the Hotel California. Glenn Frey wrote the song about the Eagles. The hotel is on the album cover, The Three Domes and Three Flags. Today, the hotel is owned by the Sultan of Brunei. He bought the hotel and did a $100 million renovation. The song Hotel Flats, Beverly Hills, known as the Flats.
You wanted to come here.
There is no home in the flats valued over $10 million. The homes in Beverly Hills range in price from $3 million to $200 million, the private homes. The $200 million home is the home of Mr. Smith, owner of Harbor Freight Tool Company. The most expensive mansion in Beverly Hills is Greystone. It was the home of Edward Doheny. That home is valued at $1 billion. It's owned by the city of Beverly Hills. Devil's Advocate, Scarface.
Ever seen those house, right?
Yeah,
there.
We saw him Friday.
Can't see it though, because it's...
Saw Friday. He's doing real good. Living in Beverly Hills and enjoying himself. It's about as unpractical of a car as you can buy, right?
Beverly Hills.
Get Santa. Spirit will love that.
Right up here on your left-hand side, we'll go by the Beverly Wilshire Hotel, built by William McCarthy. It opened in 1929 at a cost of $3 million. And that's where Richard Gere takes Julia Roberts in the movie Pretty Woman. And Warren Beatty lives at that hotel year-round.
Where is it?
And that brings us right up to Rodeo Drive. And if you like to spend money, this is a place to come here. Spend all the money that you could imagine here and more.
I got it.
Oh, see, Louis Vuitton, Jimmy Choo,
Zara Lazan.
Oh, these Lazan
places. Eddie Murphy walks up the steps of the movie Beverly Hills Cop. The City Hall was completed in construction in 1930. Next to the City Hall over here is the Beverly Hills Police Station. That's where they've had people locked up like Lindsay Lohan, Paris Hilton, Winona Ryder, Nicole Richie, Britney Spears, and Charlie Sheen. That's a lot of fun there. Yeah, they like to go in there and get arrested. They call up their attorney, weeping, right?
Oh, no. Beverly Hills experience. What do you think? What do you have to say about this?
This has been an interesting experience. Most of the stuff that I found out, I already knew.
Yeah, I knew it. I knew it too. I'm trying to tell you.
Okay, we're going to come up to Doheny Drive here. Now, Doheny Drive is the eastern border of Edward Doheny's property. He owned 431 square acres of Beverly Hills, the founder of Standard Oil. And this would be the division of the ranchos. On the other side today would be West Hollywood, of course, but in the old days, that would have been Rancho La Brea. Rancho La Brea money, that's the oldest trick in the book, right? They always use taxes against you. Anyway, Jose Jorge didn't have enough money to pay it, so he signed the property. It was built for Maria Rita, you know, a long time ago, you know, in the 1700s. That was, that's in downtown Los Angeles at a museum, that home is. There's a lot of famous adobes in California. I have a book on them, and I don't know all of them. I know some of them, but there's like a lot of famous adobe houses that are all through the state. Yep. That house was built for Charlie Chaplin. That was a dressing room for Charlie Chaplin. Yeah, famous building there. The next building on the right here, this white building, it says 882 Doheny. That was the apartment complex where Marilyn Monroe lived. Right here, 882 Marilyn Monroe. Marilyn Monroe was an orphan. She lived at Holly Grove Orphanage in Hollywood, right next to Paramount Pictures. So she would have seen the movie stars and producers coming and going as a little girl. And Holly Grove Orphanage is still in business today. Yeah, Bud Bundy, yeah. He made a lot of money on that show. Plus they get, you know, residuals, right? Like Charlie Sheen, Charlie Sheen makes more money than anybody. They play 2.5 men around the world 24 hours a day. Every time that movie's shown, right, one of those shows are shown, he gets a check, you know what I mean? So he has constant, plus he already has hundreds of millions of dollars. But if you can get a hit show, a TV show like that, you know, the syndicated, yeah, a lot of wealthiest celebrity that was as dead as Schultz, the Peanuts. That's a comedy store that's owned by Mitzi Shore, Pauly Shore's mother. Yeah. Up on the right-hand side, you see that tall building up there with the lights on it, the Art Deco building? That's the Sunset Tower. That was built by Art Deco. That was a Playboy Club. Most famous for they made a movie about it. I never got to see that movie. I saw a trailer of it, of parts of the movie, and they show the building in the movie. You think of all the wild parties and stuff they've had there over the years, huh? Imagine. Imagine. Saddle Ranch, that was John Wayne's place in the old days. It's a little Orwellian now with all the cameras and everywhere, you know, screens and it's like Orwell now. The Carneys on your left there, Art Carney, Jackie Gleason's neighbor, the honeymooners, put that there. The Standard over here, the sign's inverted. That means the building's in distress. They've had a lot of boy band parties over the years. And the Cabo Cantina on your left, that's owned by Fabio. And Fabio owns the Cantina in Hollywood, and Fabio owns the one on Santa Monica. Yeah, he owns three Cabos, yeah. Up here on the right, we'll go by the Body Shop. That's where Demi Moore did scenes of Striptease. The Body Shop burned down one time. Motley Crue sang about girls, girls, girls on the Sunset Strip. The White Castle on your left, the Chateau Marmont. That's where the cleaning lady found John Belushi dead at the age of 33 years old, an overdose of cocaine and heroin. And that goes back to the days of Clark Gable, Gene Harlow, Howard Hughes. Jim Morrison used to stay there. And Lady Gaga stays there today. Lady Gaga. Lindsay Lohan was thrown out for not paying her bill. Lindsay Lohan ran up a bill for $750,000. $750,000. Yeah, I got a book on that. On that, like, naughty celebrity stuff. It's called, I can't remember the name of it. It's a Hollywood Insider Babylon thing. There's like three Babylon books. Over on the right hand side, you can see the Chase Bank and the McDonald's Plaza and all that. In the old days, that was the Garden of Allah. It was a swimming pool with palm trees and bungalows, and it was exclusively used by wealthy people and movie stars, right? And then one day they paved paradise and put up a parking lot. Joni Mitchell wrote a song about it. And Kid Rock did a remake, Big Yellow Tax, about paving the Garden of Allah. But there's pictures of it around Hollywood if you go into the old stores. I've seen pictures of what it looked like. You know, Rudolph Valentino would dance, you know, would dance with girls there and everything. Up here on the left-hand side, we'll go by the Laugh Factory. Of course, that's where Justin Bieber ran paparazzi with his sports car right out front here. Over on the left, we'll go by the Sunset Car Wash. That's where Richard Pryor and George Carlin filmed the movie Car Wash right there. And over on the right is the Directors Guild. In the old days, that was the Menendez Building right there. That was in the 80s, it was Menendez Building.
Well, probably.
And this is Fairfax. This is the dividing line of Hollywood and West Hollywood. Rascal shows were made there. And that brings us back to Hollywood Boulevard. Hollywood was scraped out of the desert by a steam-powered bulldozer in 1899. It was called Prospect Avenue, and they brought the railroad this way. The railroad went all the way down to the ocean at one time. And then they took the railroad out, and they changed it to Hollywood Boulevard in the late 20s. And that's where we're at now. Oh, they're towing cars that are parked here. You're not allowed to park here after dark. See that? That guy's going to come out to get his car, and it's going to be gone.
That car was close.
He didn't read the signs.
Really?
I always read the signs, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, you gotta read the signs around here.
Somebody's car got wrecked.
I don't want my car towed.